Hello all, I am Raji Espile from Department of Computer Applications. As we all know, we are moving through a difficult situation and we are all are doing our part practicing social distancing and staying at home. So this is a good time to spend time with our family and also moving into virtual connectivity world through video conferencing, webinars, etc. So as a small initiative from Department of Computer Applications, we have developed a simple video tutorial to develop online video lectures. So the outcome of this video is to create a video just like what you are being. In this method, we are not using any costly tools. We are making use of a free software called Screencast-O-Matic, which is used to make online video lectures. So let us see what are the basic requirements. The first one is that a well prepared PowerPoint presentation, and using Screencast-O-Matic, we can prepare only video lectures of maximum 15 minutes duration. So plan accordingly, make your PPT precise and concise. Then laptop or PC with webcam and microphone for the browser part, preferably Chrome or Firefox. And then you need a Gmail account that for uploading your video into YouTube. Then of course a good internet connection. The software we are using is called Screencast-O-Matic. It is a free software for screen recording, and what we are using and what we are doing here is we are just running our PPT in a slideshow mode and adding narration to it and storing it as a multimedia content. So let us move on. To launch Screencast-O-Matic, just type Screencast-O-Matic in your browser. Then a window like this will be displayed. Click on this launch free recorder. On clicking, a pop-up window just as shown below will be displayed with two options. Then click on this open screen recorder launcher. Then a free recorder will be displayed on your screen with these three options, that is screen, webcam and both. For screen option, if you are selecting screen option, only screen, only your computer screen will be captured. If you are selecting webcam, the webcam recording only, maybe your face will be captured. And if you are selecting both, both your screen and your webcam recording will be displayed. Here I have selected screen, so that is why you are viewing only my screen. Then as I mentioned, the time limit is 15 minutes. Here you can adjust it, and the narrations can be added. And of course the size, you can select the size, active window, full screen. Here I have selected the full screen mode. So after setting up all options, click on this record option. Here we go. Put the PPT that you have kept ready on slideshow mode, then start lecturing. This stop button will be displayed on your screen. After recording is over, click on stop button or click on this done link. A window as shown below will be displayed. Click on this save and upload link. On clicking save and upload link, a video with saving options will be displayed. Click on the save as video file. By default, the type will be MP4, and you can rename the name. By default it will be recording number. You can select, I can change it and specify the folder. On clicking this folder, you can specify the path or the folder to which this your video is to be stored. By default it will be desktop. Then hit on this publish button. Here we go, the saving is being done. So when you see this window on your screen, means that our lecture video is ready in our specified folder. So in order to share it with our students through online platforms and all, let us upload it into the YouTube. For uploading this video into YouTube, just log in into your Gmail account. There in the extreme left you can see Google Apps icon. Click on that. The Google Apps will be displayed. Click on YouTube, and uploading video to YouTube is really easy. Here click on this video camera icon, and drop down menu with two options will be displayed, that is upload video and go live. Click on this upload video. Here select the file to be uploaded from your specific folder. Then the details of your recording will be added. Then the visibility mode, and here you have a link over here, and this link, copy this link, and this link is being shared through online platforms or like WhatsApp or email or anything. You can share it among your students, and they can access, they can use this link to access your videos. So that is it. Hope you all enjoy creating multimedia content with these simple and free tools. Thank you and stay safe.